a real UPSC aspirant. A real UPSC aspirant is one, for him, any shock is no shock. He goes to the examination, sees the question paper. Instead of GS question paper, let us presume psychology question paper is given to him. And he says, okay, we will write UPSC real aspirant. Are we understanding? Who has got no preconceived notions? He is open-minded, ready to do anything as per the demands of the examination. A real UPSC aspirant, I am speaking. He doesn't say, sir, I have to get up early in the morning, only at 6 o'clock. He is ready to get up even at 4 o'clock. And he is ready to wake the whole night also before the examination. And UPSC aspirant is one who is ready to take whatever it takes to clear this examination. Food, no problem. Comfort, suffering, sir, accepted, both we are accepting. On one day, instead of history question, I said that it is an history test. I put geography question. Person says, we will write, no problem. Are we understanding? Some area he has not studied. He has calculatively eliminated the area in the syllabus. And he goes to the examination. He sees that the first question is from that area. He says, we will write later. That will be our last answer, we will write. He plans. He is a real UPSC aspirant, whom I am mentioning. A real UPSC aspirant is open-minded, adaptive, adjustable. He can accept anything. You understand, you people? You cannot, in fact, insult a real UPSC aspirant. Maybe in the first year, he is calling himself an aspirant, but he is not an aspirant. Because he is still affected by these so-called emotions, societies, those four people in the societies. First year, he is not an aspirant, but he is calling himself an aspirant. Later, he becomes so resistive. Anybody use, some people come and tell you are good for nothing. He smiles at them, thank you. Some people say that now you have become great, you have got service, so you are a very great person. The person says, okay. For him, good, bad, he sees in the same light. And he doesn't peak or down. Always normalcy. That is why, mostly when a person has spent quite some time in the UPSC preparation, his emotional quotient also is very stable. Suddenly, a girl comes and says, you are so beautiful. It's okay. And some girl comes and says, you are the dumbest person ever. He says, okay, no problem. UPSC aspirant. Are we understanding? And if you are of this caliber, there is no way in which the UPSC can eliminate you from selecting. And you are always ready for the examination. Rain, shine, health, hill, health. Every time you are ready for the examination. You don't say, sir, I need more time, sir. Why don't you give me 2 more days for preparing the examination? All these reasons many people used to tell. Sir, my pen is not writing properly. That is why my handwriting is not proper. Actually, the paper which you gave, no, this is not okay. The paper is somewhat not okay. That's why my handwriting is not okay. Some people say the font which you are giving, comments students are sending me. Because of the fonts in the question paper, I cannot write answers. Because the font is very irritating, they are telling. One line question, but still there is a font irritating. Till he has not become UPSC aspirant. So, sir, what we have to do? I didn't have to do anything. UPSC will do. What, sir? They will ask him to wait 1 more year. And after, the person had become totally enlightened. No, there is no complaints. He doesn't complain. You will know a simple indication of whether a person is a proper UPSC aspirant or not is that he doesn't complain. He is okay with everything. He doesn't complain at all. And he says, it is not because of this I have not done. He doesn't say. He doesn't speak. You understand? He just performs. He minds his own business. So I am telling all of you, there are some people who are just aspirants, now become real aspirants. then only success would be guaranteed.